In this short Photoshop tutorial, I'll share with you how to change backdrop color easily in Photoshop using two methods. What's up, Charlie? My name is Kwekwaye and this is Ghananie Photography. On this channel, I share with you awesome photography tutorials. So if this is something that's of interest to you, you should consider subscribing and hit the bell so you get notified anytime there's a new upload. You can see here how easy it is for us to change the color of the backdrop by just sliding on the hue slider. So let me delete this and let's start from scratch. This is our original backdrop. It's blue. The first way we'll do this is by using the hue saturation adjustment layer. There are two ways to get to the hue saturation adjustment layer. First of all, we can just click on this and it brings it up, or we come down here and then hue saturation. It does the same thing. This is a solid color backdrop and unfortunately we don't have the same color on our model, so we can just go ahead without doing a selection. When you come here, you see master, click on it and it shows you the various solid colors. Luckily, we are using blues and there is blue here. So just click on the blues and let's slide on the hue. And as easy as that, we are able to change the color to any color that we want. Let's say we want it somewhere here. We keep it like that. Now you have the options of working on the saturation or the lightness. So for the saturation, it's either you want it deeper or lighter, something like this. And then for the lightness, either you want it darker or brighter. So basically, this is how you do it with this particular method. Now, what if you're not fortunate enough and you have some of the colors in the model's dress? So that takes us to the other way of doing this same one, but then using a selection. So let's delete this. And to select your subject, you select this quick selection tool. And then over here, we see select subject. So just click on it. And fortunately, Photoshop does a very good job of selecting your subject. But if you realize that it's not well selected, you can refine your selection by using the option key and then adding or subtracting your selection. Alternatively, you can go to select and mask, which brings you to this menu, and you can tweak some of these values to fit what you want to do. Once you're done, you select output to selection over here and click OK. Now this has refined our selection for us. So let's now do our hue saturation again. And this time, you see we have a layer mask. So don't get confused yet. Now the layer mask is for our selection. So if we come here and we start moving this, see, it affects only our selection. It's restricted to only what we have selected, which is our subject. So if we change any color here, that's the effect we get on the model. So how do we move this effect from our subject to the backdrop, since the backdrop is our main interest, right? It's easy. Just make sure the layer mask is selected. Then you go to image, adjustments, and invert. And just like that, the selection has been inverted to our backdrop. So anything we do with our hue saturation affects only the backdrop. I hope you are not confused yet. So when we select our hue saturation here, this comes back, so we can always change the color. So just like we did in the previous one, just that this particular one gives you a restricted area to work with, so that if your model has any of the colors of the backdrop in her dress, those colors won't be affected. Now that we are satisfied with this, let's move to the second method. With that also, we need to select our subject. Pick our quick selection tool, select subject. The same thing, you can refine it and do order. So we click on select and mask. And and then make your changes here, and then don't forget to output to selection. Okay, now once we are here, we go to adjustment layer and then solid color. So once this pops up, select any color you want and that will fill in our selection, but we want this color to affect the backdrop instead of our selection. So just click OK, just choose any color at all and then click OK. We'll get back to that. So make sure you select your layer mask and then you go to image adjustments and then invert once again. So you see it has inverted the selection. So our effect now is on the backdrop. So if you want to change the color, just double tap on that and then just like that you can select any color you want. See, any color you want, and that will take over your image. With this, if you have a textured backdrop and you want to maintain the shadows and all that, all you have to do is with the blend mode, you come to multiply or you go to color. So by doing this, you're able to maintain the texture and the shadows on the original backdrop. Check out these other videos and let me know in the comment section if this has been helpful to you. I hope this has been informative for you, and I would like to thank you for watching.